everybody. It is a brew day, and I've blown both of my kegs. The unforgivable sin of homebrewers. So I am here to brew. I'm actually going to be working on my SC Port Challenge beer, the first beer. By the way, registration is open, if you didn't know that. For the SC Port Challenge, just go to sjporrchallenge.org. It is open. So I am working on the round one beer today. So I really can't tell you a lot about that beer. I can tell you a few things. I can. It's going to have some caramel malt. It's going to have some base malt. It's going to have an American yeast. And I can also tell you it's going to have the 3C hops. But first, I got to clean these kegs. So I got a question for you guys. I just recently switched back to PBW. I've been using OxiClean for quite a while. And the biggest problem I've heard with people with OxiClean is they let it sit, stuff sit in OxiClean for a long period of time. I don't ever let stuff sit more than a half hour. I've never had problems with building up scale, but at the suggestion, I went ahead and went back to this. And going through the instructions, they say that you need to use 3/4 of an ounce per gallon. That's like, what is that? 3 and 3.75 ounces for 5 gallons? That's like a lot. I mean, you would just wipe this out fast. Do you guys use that much? I'm just curious. Let me know. All right, it's time to get the water going here. There we go. I said every time, I love having set up the filter like this. It works great. Looks like I've sprung a little leak here. I'm gonna have to cut that and recrimp it, but oh well. All right, 22 liters where we're starting today. It's time to get the show on. Off we go. Rock and roll. We are there. It is time to mash in. All right. So, meanwhile, I've got one of the kegs that's sanitized, or I should say cleaned, and the other one's in the middle of sanitizing. I gotta tell you, if you're not crushing your own grains, that's cool. I didn't for years, but I love the crush. I just get such an amazing crush every time now. It's a beautiful thing. I used the barley crusher. Been super happy with it. I gave it a dunk in the sanitizer once again and popped that in. Puppy on top. Put on the nut. Go. I love it. Need to raise up just a little bit on this side, I'd say. There, that's a bit more even. So while we're mashing it over here, I'm gonna start running the PBW through the lines inside. Well, I've got the sparge water heating up. I managed to get all the beer lines, the two tap lines cleaned. One keg sitting over here on the side, it's done. The other one's just sitting in sanitizer, and I'll pressurize that, set that aside, it'll be ready to go. And this is just about ready, I think. Oh yeah, right on time. Okay, it's time to get on with the next part. Alright, well, the water's heating. I'm going to just check and see what the first rungs are at for fun. I'll put that in the fridge to let it cool down to the right temp first. So while the last of that's settling to the bottom, we're going to go ahead and start the boil. So we got to bring that up from 66 Celsius to 100 and let her rip. All right, we've hit the hot break and it's boiling, baby. So here we go. First hops. You know it's one of the sea hops, right? Smells wonderful too. Have to say, I need to use that hop more often. Well, I've already added yeast nutrient. I will tell you, I added some hops at 15 minutes, and you can be sure they were probably either Cascade or Centennial or Columbus. One of those three C's. Ding, ding, ding. 5 minutes. Another ounce of hops. Woo-hoo. All right, we're at the 1 minute mark. Got another ounce of hops. And she's done. And the way I've been doing it is I have my chiller just soaking in the sanitizer the whole time. So we're gonna pop that in there. Got empty buckets down below. So I like to use the water and water the tree and stuff after I get rid of the first hot stuff. The mash pipe's already been cleaned, that's been set aside. So everything else is basically all clean and ready to rock and roll. All right. Okay, so basically, we're gonna chill this down a little bit. I'm gonna get it down to about 185 and then I'm putting in another ounce. I'll tell you that much, that's what you know. But I will catch you later. We're gonna get this baby chilled down and packed away. I got my firm wrap to put around it, and I'm gonna probably keep it around 67, 68 consistently. All right, you guys have a great week. Happy Homebrew Wednesday.